Now, our previous video, we have discussed what is page replacement algorithm, why we need page replacement algorithm. We have discussed our first page replacement algorithm, that is FIFO. In this current video, we will be discussing our second page replacement algorithm, that is LRU. Let us see the definition of LRU. Replace the page that has not been used for longest period of time. So, when one particular page should be replaced, it should be replaced with the page which is not used for a longer time. Before we discuss how it is, let us see the present scenario. We have page references by CPU are 7, 0, 1, 2, 0, up to 1. And these are the pages where the instruction referred by CPU is present. Simply we can tell, let's say CPU want to perform one addition operation which is present in page 7. Page 7 may consist of so many things, but because we want to execute A plus B which is present in page 7, so I need to bring whole page of page 7. In disk, I have all those pages stored. It is for a particular process. You can see here page number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. All those are up to 7 are part of a process which needs to be part of a particular process which needs to be executed. And these are the pages CPU is referring. First 7, then 0, then 1 and 2. Like that. So when page 7 is referenced by CPU, it should be checked that whether the page 7 is present in memory, main memory or not. If it is not, for page 7, there will be a page fault. Fault means there is some mistake. Page 7 has to be executed according to CPU, so it should be present in main memory, but it is not present. So there is a fault. 7 should be present in main memory, but it is not present. And to remove that fault, what we have to do is we have to bring page 7 from virtual memory to main memory. When we will bring the page from virtual memory to main memory, we will keep the page in free location of main memory. That free location is called frame. You can see here frame 1, frame 2 and frame 3 available for the particular process we are going to execute. Now the question is, why number of frames are 3 in main memory? Is it actually 3? No, it is not actually 3. For simplicity, we have just assumed that number of frames available in main memory to accommodate that particular process which has to be executed now are 3. In real life, it may be more than 3, it may be less than 3. Now, come back to the position where we were there originally. So, by CPU, first page reference is 7. So, we need to bring page 7 to main memory. Before we bring, we should check whether page 7 is present or not. If it is not present, we will consider it as a first page fault and we should bring page 7 to main memory. So, what we should do in frame 1, we should bring the first page reference by CPU to main memory from virtual memory. Next page reference is 0. Is 0 present in other two frames, frame 2 and frame 3? No, it is not present. So, it should be brought. So, this will be considered as second page fault because of 0 not present in the memory. So the result of second page fault is 0 should be brought from virtual memory to main memory. Then third page fault will occur because 1 is also not present in the main memory. So 1 has to be brought from virtual memory to main memory. So 1 will occupy the frame 3. 7 frame 0, 0 frame 1 and 1 will occupy frame 3. Now for that particular process, allotted frame numbers are only 3. So only 3 frames are only presently occupied. So what will happen is for page 2, what will be the situation for page 2? No free frames are available for page 2. But page 2 has to be brought. So one among these three pages has to be replaced. Which one should be replaced should be decided by the currently used page replacement algorithm. According to LRU, which page will be replaced is the page which is not been used for a longer time. To find out which one is not been used for a longer time, we should just see the references from current position to back. Currently, which one is used? 1. Previous to that, which one is used? 0. Previous to that, which one is used? 7. So, which one is not used for a longer time? Obviously, 7. So, 7 should be replaced. Replaced by which one? 2. I'll repeat once again. 2 has to be brought to the main memory for execution. There is no place available for 2. So, 2 should replace 1 among these 3 pages. So, which one will be replaced according to least recently used? Which is not been used for a longer time. 1 is used, 0 is used previous to that, and 7 is used previous to that. So, 7 should be replaced. So, when 2 will be brought, 7 will be replaced. Next reference is for 0. See here, 0 is already present. So, there will not be any page fault. So, because of arrival of 0, the frame picture will remain same. That is previously also 201, now also 201. There is no page fault occurred here. The page required is already present. Next reference is for page 3. Page 3 is present here? No, not present here. So, 3 has to be brought and 1 page should be replaced. Which one should be replaced? Which is least recently used? See here, 0 is currently used. Previous to that, 2 is used. Previous to that, 1 is used. So, among 2, 3 and 1, 1 is used in longer past. So, 1 will be replaced. So, 3 will take the place of 1. See here, 0 we need now. 0 is already present. So, there will not be any change in frame. It will remain as it is, that is 203. Next page we need is, if you need is 4. 4 should be replaced by, see here, 0, 3 and 2. Among 2, 0 and 3, 2 is used for longest period of, is used longest period of time back. Means compared to 0 and 3, 2 was referred before. So, 2 should be replaced. So, 4 will take the place of 2. Now, 2 is required among 4, 0 and 3. You see here, 4, 0 and 3. 3 is the oldest one. So, 2 will take the place of 3. We need 3 now. Among 4, 0 and 2, 0 is the oldest one. So, 3 will take the place of 0. Now, we need to bring page 0. See here, among 4, 3 and 2, which one is the oldest? 4 is oldest. 3 is recently, then 2, then 4. So, 4 will be replaced. So, 0 will take the place of 4. We need 3. 3 is already present. So, there is no page fault. I will repeat the same frame once again. Same frame. I should tell you that this, if you don't write also, if you keep it just empty like that, then also it is not at all a problem. But while we write the replica of the same thing, just to make it clear, like if we don't write, we will be feeling somewhat like what was there. So, for safer side, better replace the same value once again. Again, the next reference is for page 2. Page 2 is already present. So, there is no page fault. I will again repeat the same thing. Next reference is for 1. 1 is not present. So, among 0, 3 and 2, 1 should be replaced. Among these 3, which one is lastly used? Is 0. So, 0 should be replaced. 1 will take the place of 0. Next reference is for 2. 2 is already present. No page fault. So, 1, 3, 2. I can copy once again. Next page reference is 0. For that again page fault will happen and replacement also should happen. So, which page will be replaced? 2 is used. 1, 1. So, 3. 3 is 1 which is used longest time before among 1, 3 and 2. So, 3 should be replaced. 0 will take the place of where was 3, there now 0 I should write. Now 1 is the next referenced page, 1 is already present, so no page fault. I should repeat 102 once again. Next we need page 7, which is not present in the main memory. So 1 among 102 should be replaced. Which one should be replaced? Last longest time back which one was used is 2 among 102. So 7, 2's place will be taken by 7. Now next reference is for 0. So 0 is already present, so no page replacement. I should write the same value again. Again, next reference is for 1. 1 is already present, so no page replacement will occur. I am writing here no because there is no page replacement. No page replacement is nothing but called hit. What is hit? I needed the page reference 0. 0 was already present, so there is no page fault. Whichever page I want, if that is already present in the main memory, is called a hit. And if it is not present, it is called miss or page fault. I will repeat once again, if the page which I require is already present in the main memory, like in this case, I needed 0 and 0 was already present. So it is called no page fault or it is called hit, means I'm successful. But the page which is required is not present, it is called miss or page fault. So where all I have got no page fault, that is hit. This is one place, this is the second place. See, you can see the value repeated. This is the third place. See, 0, 3, 2. Is repeated here and here. See, here there was a page fault, but for 3 was present, so no page fault. Next reference was 2 was present, so no page fault. Next, again we can see after 1, 3, 2, here it is repeated, so no page fault. Here is no page fault. Here this and this, no page fault. First time it was a page fault, but this and this cases it is not a page fault because 0 we need was present, 1 we need was present. Remaining all the places will fill with page fault. We will place it with F. F means what? Page fault or miss. And N means what? No page fault or hit. We usually calculate the hit ratio. What is hit ratio? Hit ratio is nothing but number of hit by total number of page references. Here we have taken 20 page references, so denominator should be 20, and if we count the number of hit, that is this n places 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So hit ratio will be 8 by 20. Similarly, we can calculate miss ratio also. So 20 minus 18, 8 should be 12. So 12 should be number of miss. So similarly, we can calculate miss ratio, which is nothing but number of miss divided by total number of page reference. If you like the video, please subscribe. Thank you so much for keeping your patience.